guys, good morning, I'm back with a new video, and this video is about binding spells and why I like them so much. Now, most of you know I'm adopted and my biological mom is quite a handful, and even though I'm very forgiving and patient and kind, she was nasty, plain mean, and she tried to kill me a couple of times, and I still didn't get angry. I was like, oh, I understand, yeah, you went through a horrible time, and I don't know, it's just me. But enough is enough, and when I have enough of all types of bullshit, I will deal with it. So I did a binding spell, and everything went back to normal, and I was ready to be happy again, and I was happy. But then I thought, well, reincarnation and things like that, other realities, different realms. What if I bump into her in the astral or in another life, a next life, or what have you? So I decided to do a complete overall binding spell to prevent things from happening again or history repeating itself, or and I felt safe, really, really safe. And did I feel the need to do a curse at the time? No, I still don't. She is gone, completely gone, as in vanished. I have no idea if she's still alive or not, and I don't care. So, but this idea of other realms and the astral and the reincarnation and next lives and past lives and time bending and sort of stuck it to me, and ever since I do a binding spell before I do a curse or a psychic attack or an ongoing psychic attack. About me doing psychic attacks, I enjoy doing psychic attacks so much that I can make somebody suffer for years and forever. So it's fun. About psychic attacks, I will do another video, but the reason that I do a binding spell before I do a hex or a curse, for example, is that my victim or target can't move around that quickly and can't fight back and is sort of really stuck in ice, in graveyard dirt, in a swamp, in covered in ivy, somewhere drowned, bind to a rock or something, and it works, it helps. I don't always do this, but it became sort of a habit to do a binding spell to prevent people from attacking me or fighting back or things like that. Now, to be on the safe side, I also do a psychic a binding on the people that are closest to my main target or victim, to prevent that these people cannot help the target or victim unbind him herself, or they will do the unbinding for my target or victim. So if I have one target, I will focus on the people that are supporting this target first, because they don't see things coming. In the meantime, my target usually gets very uncomfortable and nervous, and because nothing is happening. That's because I'm working on his or her inner circle. Then I do a binding spell on my target, and then I do a curse or a psychic attack or an ongoing psychic attack. I like ongoing psychic attacks because it makes it easy for me to release anger and enjoy myself at the same time and paralyze somebody slowly, or things like that. And it's just to be on the safe side. You can, of course, start cursing right away, but then you never know what the people around the victim, the support system or the inner circle will do to help the target. And also, when somebody is eliminated, what's going to happen? If somebody is really obsessed with you, or really focused on you, or focused too much on you, then he or she will probably be focused on you too in the afterlife. And that's what you don't want, because then you're fighting a ghost or an entity or a demon or something like that. And my advice is to do a binding before you start a psychic deck or a curse, to be on the safe side, and make it an all over covering everything kind of binding, so you won't bump into your enemy in the astral or in another realm or another reality, or maybe forget about him or her and have to go through the whole thing again in next life. That's what you don't want. So do a binding spell, then you start doing a curse and or a psychic attack. So, and don't forget the inner circle and the support system of your victim, because you don't want them to have and use their power to help your victim. So that's it. Very quick, very simple, and just a piece of advice. See you next time. Bye.